Question 31. Again, we're now after question 30. We're back to solving for just on this interval from 0 to 2 pi. However, we've got a little bit more complicated stuff we're dealing with. We'll actually have two solutions. So this is getting, when we have factored, remember this is like a times b. We've got two things multiplied that give us 0. What that means is each of them could be 0. The only way you can multiply and get 0 is if one of the factors is 0. So either, so we come here, let's get our, yeah, that's good. So we're going to find that either either 2 cosine x plus 1 equals 0, so that's that first one, or cosecant plus 1 equals 0. Okay, so we'll solve the first one first. We're probably more comfortable with cosine. Subtract 1 from both sides. 2 cosine of x equals negative 1. Divide by 2. Cosine of x equals negative 1 half. So we look on the unit circle for all the places where cosine would be equal to 1 half. And when we do that, we see cosine is the x. It happens first at pi over 3. Oh, no, no. Negative 1 half, right? Make sure you, yeah, negative 1 half. Doesn't happen there. That's positive 1 half. Negative 1 half's over here. So 2 pi over 3, and then the other place all the way down here, 4 pi over 3. So the two places, 2 pi over 3, 4 pi over 3, the x coordinate is negative 1 half, making the cosine of, that's where the x, what did we say? 1 half. 2 pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, and 4 pi, right? It was down here. Cosine, x, 4 pi over 3. Two places that it happens. The other places, the cosine would be positive. Okay, so there's two answers. Before I start putting them in, I'm going to solve this one. So this one, we subtract 1 from both sides. So we get cosecant equals negative 1. So where does that happen? Cosecant of x. We have to remember cosecant. What is cosecant? And again, at the beginning, we did all of this stuff. Cosecant. Cosecant is 1 over sine. So thinking of 1 over sine of x, well, the only place that would happen is if sine of x was negative 1 half, right? Yeah, you could multiply both sides by sine x, you know, using algebra. And that gives you, cancel, gets you 1 equals negative sine x. Multiply by negative 1 because we want to get positive sine x. So that's negative 1 equals sine x. So anywhere sine x is equal to negative 1, cosecant is going to be equal to negative 1. Well, where does that happen? One place only. The y value is negative 1 down here at 3 pi over 2. That's where the sine is negative 1. Only one place. Sine is positive 1 up here, and there's no other place. It's just, this is it. The north and south pole. That's what you can get. So we're at the south pole. So x on this case equals, what was that? 3 pi over 2? 3 pi over 2. So those are the four. Again, we don't really have to have them in order, but that's kind of why I was holding off, and we actually have them in order now. So we've got this one, which is 2 pi over 3. Let's do that, and then that. 4 pi over 3. Oops. Sometimes you get in a hurry and it makes you go slower. 4 pi over 3. And then the last one is 3 pi over